broadcasting from the raw space at the historic Sprinkle Theater in America's finest city. This is Tonight in San Diego. This week's guest, Jenny Siebold from Brew It Yourself. KUSI's Allie Wagner. Tonight's musical guest, Caroline Korn. With the Mondaze featuring DJ Teelyn. I'm Keith Foster.
I got it right that time. Thank you guys so much for coming out to Tonight in San Diego. Welcome, everyone. Thank you. So please say hello to my beautiful co-host here, Keith Foster. Nice to see you, Keith.
Nice to see you, sir.
And of course, the Mondaze with DJ Teelyn. So you have the fourth chair filled now, it looks like.
We have Brian Hiller, everybody.
Very nice. So I guess our first test for your new guest in the band is, can they do the headlines theme? Shall we test it out?
Yeah, let's try it out.
Hey, let's do some headlines. Yeah! I think he made the cut. All right, a young boy was in Oklahoma was believed to have the stomach flu until doctors discovered he'd swallowed 8 magnets. Doctors grew suspicious when the boy arrived on the outside of the ambulance. Okay. The magnets were in his diaper, maybe, I don't know. A principal in Iowa has decided not to punish a group of 9th grade girls for hiring a male stripper. When asked why, the principal responded with, "Hey, I needed the money." Is that the principal? Okay. Looks a little like you, Keith. That's okay. Earlier this week, a 2.8 magnitude earthquake struck the wealthy residents of La Jolla. The community is in mourning over the loss of thousands of Fabergé eggs. Keith, I know you have a Fabergé egg collection, don't you? How do you feel about that tragedy?
I would be devastated if I lost any of my little frabbies.
That's what you call them, frabbies?
Frabbies.
So you're a Fabergé fan? Is there a name for that? Is that...
Yeah, frab fans.
Frab fans, okay.
I don't know where the R came from.
I don't know either. Fabergé?
Fabergé.
You might be getting a cheap knockoff, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I actually collect Cadbury eggs, but it's a different thing.
Those are creamier, Jesse.
They are creamy, they're delicious. A shuttle bus for Apple employees caught fire this week. Not to be outdone, Samsung released its new bus with twice as much fire and a better camera.
You know, Windows Phone tried to catch their bus on fire, but nobody cared.
No, everybody still wanted that fiery Apple bus. 6 people have been arrested here in San Diego for breaking into homes through garages. Yeah. The burglars were caught making off with hundreds of paint cans, oily rags, and an old badminton set. Pretty sweet. In the gas lamp, a DA investigator was suspended after biting the rear end of a female prosecutor at a bar, making this the first legal case where DA stands for dead ass.
Dead ass, Jesse.
Dead ass, though.
Dead ass.
Dead ass, Keith. Bajan wrote that. Local brewery Green Flash is set to debut a series of limited edition craft beers, each available for one day only. These beers are best enjoyed sipped through a handlebar mustache while riding an old-timey bicycle. That looks like you, Keith.
It looks a lot like me, Jesse.
It does.
These beers are best enjoyed as they are meant to be delivered. That way you can really taste the full body pretension.
That's true. I heard you drink yours out of half of a Fabergé egg. Is that
yes.
true?
Yes. Just crack it in half, get rid of the creamy center, drink a little
bit. Even Fabergé eggs have a creamy center? I guess I don't know much
All
about
All eggs Fabergé. Have creamy centers, Jesse.
All right. In other beer news, beer company Red Stripe went to trial for calling themselves a Jamaican lager when it is actually made in Pennsylvania. Yeah, I had the same issue with my cousin when he got dreadlocks and started calling himself Ja-C.
Your cousin looks a lot like you.
He does. He does. Look.
You know, I'm noticing a theme this week.
Photoshop?
Yeah.
North Korea has blocked Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube from their nation, but not before making a smug post about going off the grid for a while.
You know, it's not really any loss. Did you follow North Korea on Facebook?
I did. A lot of vague booking.
Yeah, you know? Mostly stuff like, I'm so upset right now. Can't talk about it on Facebook, though.
Yeah, I think after this joke, they're just going to just want to do one of those posts with no words that just says the emotion. Feeling annoyed.
Oh, my God. What's wrong, North Korea? Tell us all about it. Don't really.
We don't want to know. Ted Cruz does not believe Americans should have the right to masturbate. So even Ted Cruz doesn't want to touch Ted Cruz. That's my favorite one. A city worker in Rancho Bernardo got his hand stuck in a water pipe last Tuesday. Meanwhile, in Ocean Beach, my cousin Ja-C got his hand stuck in a different kind of water pipe. Guy gets into a lot of trouble. All right, and those are headlines. All right, next up to talk about the Padres season, we go to special guest and sports correspondent, Dallas McLaughlin.
There you go. All right. Thank you, Jesse. Now, for most San Diegans, it should come as no surprise that the Padres are once again bad. In fact, it kind of feels good that they're bad. You know what I mean? Like, we like what's familiar. As people, we like what's familiar. A warm cup of coffee in the morning, a good book at night, another Fast and Furious movie. We like what we know. You know what I mean? And the one thing as San Diego sports fans that we do know is mediocrity. That's right. And this year, the Padres have taken their mediocrity to new heights. Or should I say, new lows. The Padres did not score a single run for the first three games of the 2016 season. And you might be thinking to yourself, that sounds a little historic. And you know why? Because it is. It is a historic thing. No team in the history of Major League Baseball has ever been held scoreless through the first three games of a season. All right, that's right. And it's kind of like being the best at stealing bags of candy from little kids on Halloween, you know? Sure, it feels good to be the best at something, but if that best something is, you know, making kids cry and grown men curse, then you might want to think about a new line of work. I think I just explained Donald Trump.
All right, Dallas. Well, sure, it's been a rough start for the Padres, but that doesn't mean the fans aren't keeping a positive attitude, right?
Positive attitude? Jesse! Oh, no. As the scoreless streak wore on, there was no positive attitude. In fact, Padres fans took to the internet with memes like this one from The Matrix. Or this one from The Natural. Or not The Natural, this one from Nature. A father and son's relationship explaining our sadness.
Simba was so good in The Natural.
Simba was probably the best part of The Natural. Him and Wilford Brimley were fantastic. It got so bad, Jesse, that one fan actually made a website called DaysSincePadresScored.com. And it got over 3,000 views in the first hour.
Okay, but the Padres eventually scored a run, though. So that must have been a real morale boost, right?
Oh, yeah. Real big morale boost. When the Padres eventually did score their first run in the fourth inning, or the third inning of their fourth game, people went nuts. I got like 20 text messages. People were calling me. A woman in our office stood up and announced it to everyone like we won the World Series, all right? But don't get too excited, Jesse, because the Padres haven't done that one either, all right? Now listen, last week it got even worse. They accomplished a new Major League Baseball record, getting shut out 5 of their first 10 games. This is something no one has ever accomplished, ever, or I guess decomplished.
I don't think decomplished is a word, Dallas.
Fine, Jesse, it's not a word, all right? But when your team's this historically bad, you get to make up words for how bad they are, all right? Like horrendified or crapalactic or Donald Trump.
All right, Dallas, calm down. Look, I'm sure the Padres' lack of runs isn't that bad, right?
Wrong! Jesse, no team, no team. Breaking the microphone, no team in the history of professional baseball has ever been this bad through their first 10 games. Think about that. Professional baseball started in 1871, just a tad under 150 years of teams who have never been this bad. The Cincinnati Red Stockings, never this bad. The Brooklyn Excelsiors, never this bad. The Chicago Cubs, the New York Gothams, the Fort Wayne Keekogans, never this bad.
Wow, really?
Yes! Jesse, yes! I mean, just think about all that has happened since professional baseball started in 1871. The Civil War just ended, and then the phone was invented, and then the zipper, and then movie cameras, and then World War II, and then there was Hitler, and then Donald Trump was born. The Godfather saga, Michael Jackson died, all right? 150 years of some of the most important inventions and events in history, yet through all that time, no team was ever as bad as the San Diego Padres are this season. All right? Now, Jesse, you're probably thinking to yourself, it can't get much worse.
I am thinking that, Dallas.
I know you are.
I'm thinking it can't get much worse, Dallas.
It can't get much worse, Jesse. I knew you were thinking that.
I was thinking that.
And you're right. You know why you're right? Because we here tonight in San Diego have decided to fire the Padres. That's right. We are firing the Padres, Jesse.
Whoa, Dallas. That's a little bit drastic, isn't it?
Not at all. All right? When you're this bad, you deserve to get fired. And if you're going to lose like this, at least make it entertaining. All right? Give the fans a reason to come to Petco and watch a horrible product. You know what I mean? So what we're going to do is we're going to fire the Padres, and we're going to hire new people to be the new Padres. All right? Well, watch this, Jesse. Here's an example of one of the people we'll be hiring.
All right.
Bill Walton. Look at that. Bill Walton.
Bill Walton. He's got a big strike zone.
Big strike zone. Yeah. That's right. And he looks happy in that photo. He looks very happy. Little John. Little John. Look, he loves the Padres. Just think about when he hits a home run and runs around the bases, the noises he'll make.
He'll get it hyped up. Absolutely.
The noises he'll make. The next person is even better. Will Ferrell. Yeah, see? He loves San Diego. Stay classy, San Diego. Hit a home run. Move the cue card. I can't see what the video is. There you go. Look at that old lady. She's probably still alive. And she's got a cannon. She's got an old-timey cannon. She's throwing it underhand. That's League of Their Own style right there. She's going to be great.
Is that legal? I don't know.
It's legal.
Okay.
There's no age limits.
Let's do it.
All right, the next up, a Tyrannosaurus Rex. Now immediately you're going to say, that could never work, but you've probably never seen a movie called Ed with Whoopi Goldberg because it worked flawlessly for her.
I have not seen that.
You haven't seen that?
No, she turns into a T-Rex in that?
I haven't seen it either, okay. But it was a big... I can only assume that she becomes a T-Rex in that movie.
I want to see that now.
She wins the NBA championship as a T-Rex.
Oh, that's a great movie.
It's a great movie. It's a part of the Air Bud series. But listen, if you believe what we believe, that we should fire the Padres and replace them with old ladies and dinosaurs, then I want you to tweet at Tonight in San Diego using the hashtag, please fire all the current Padres and replace them with the Padres that Dallas just suggested on this show.
That's an incredibly long hashtag.
Jesse, it's an incredibly long season.
That is true. All right, thank you very much, Dallas. Give it up for Dallas. And of course, you can find out more of Dallas's sports thoughts at kepfaith.com. All right, everybody, we'll be right back right after this. We have a great show coming up. Jenny Seabolt from Brew It Yourself is here. Let's hear it for her. We've got KUSI's Allie Wagner coming up. And tonight's musical guest, Caroline Korn. We'll be right back. Stick around.
That was fun.
are back with Jenny Seabolt from Brew It Yourself. Jenny, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. We love beer. And so,
me too.
So this is how we brew it ourselves, is this rig here?
Yeah, oops. Yeah. Actually, so what we've come up with is kind of a really simplified system. So that when people come to us and come to our craft beer workshops, we want them to be able to take what they learned and just physically do that at home.
Okay.
In case prohibition ever kicks back in.
Right. Sure, like, right. We want to have good neighbors, you know, you want to make sure everybody's got a nice supply at home. So we can brew on the fancier equipment, the more advanced equipment, and actually Helms affords us to do that.
Helms is the brewery?
Helms is our sponsored brewery, yes.
Okay.
So we do all of our brewing on Helms Brewery floor ground, so where they're actually brewing. Their production beer is where we're actually brewing as well.
So this is the normal setup that I actually tried making malt liquor on a George Foreman grill once, but it didn't work out as well as I would have hoped.
You didn't bring any
Sherry in then? I thought it was delicious.
He liked it, but you know, he likes Fabergé eggs, so. So this is, you make beer out of rabbit pellets? Is that what that is?
Uh-huh, yep. Those are fresh from our rabbit farm at home.
Okay.
No, these are actually hot pellets. So you can actually kind of, if you rub them between your fingers, you can kind of get the aroma a little bit. Hops are actually a flower, and they grow on a vine. They grow really well here in San Diego, too.
Weird, it actually does smell like rabbit pellets.
You do this a lot with rabbit pellets.
I do handle a lot of turds.
Good for you. Good for you.
Yeah.
It's not weird at all.
I don't know if you want to use these again. Now.
No. No, not if you have rabbit poo on
your
hands.
I'm just going to pocket these for later.
So, yeah, these basically...
Hops,
as you know, are really big in San Diego. And there's all kinds of different hops. This is kind of a simplified version to brew with because they're in a nice, neat little pellet for you. It's a lot less messy.
Okay, and then, so, what are these things here?
So these are actually some of the grains that that you brew with typically. This is a very common Pilsner grain.
Okay.
And I actually brought some because I wanted you to actually eat some.
You want me to eat some?
Mm-hmm.
Is this, okay.
All right.
They're edible. I'll eat them with you.
Oh, all right. I'm going to eat them first?
I mean, it's just a typical grain. Yeah, true.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
They're really not that bad, but...
Typical. So...
The reason I have you do that is because it gives you a little bit of an understanding of where the malty flavor of your beer comes
from,
right?
So it comes from the grain?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So you eat these and then this comes later. Is that what's going on?
Yeah.
Okay, so...
I don't think most people eat them. It's just like the weird thing I make you guys do.
Okay.
And honestly, when our brewers are brewing with us, I encourage them to do that as well. If you know, the more familiar you are with your ingredients, just the same as in cooking or making a cocktail or something, then you kind of understand your product a little bit
if
more.
If I eat enough of those, will I get drunk?
Yeah, I was going to ask you that.
It's a good experiment. I encourage you to try.
We'll try.
No, you certainly won't. So there's actually a substance in here, and that's what takes the sugar out.
I don't know why I keep eating it, by the way.
I told you, they're not bad.
That's great. Can I spit them out
it's
like sunflower
seeds? So it's like we have to just
you
like,
can put them back.
There's nothing in that green room, so I'm just eating this.
So they all taste different, and they all produce a different flavor to your beer. Some of them give them a different color. As you can see, these are a much darker malt.
Okay. I thought that was coffee.
This isn't, but the beer that we have here today is actually one of Helms's more popular recipes. It's called Birichino.
Oh.
And that actually is brewed with coffee.
Very nice. So this has coffee in it?
This has coffee in it. It's been brewed with coffee. It's actually a local coffee as well, which is kind of cool. They're Bird Rock Roastery, or I believe, something like that. They're out of La Jolla.
Okay.
And so that's kind of
what
inspired the beer.
It smells just like coffee.
It does.
Yeah. It definitely has a flavor of coffee, too.
Cheers.
One of the things, cheers.
Mm. It'd be good in the morning with eggs.
Actually, I'm told that that's where it came from. The brewer was really hungover and...
Is that right?
And needed like a little caffeine, and so he came up with this, and it's been really popular.
How did you get started in this home brewing world?
Well, it was actually my husband's fault.
Of course.
And it was actually something he was really good at and really passionate about.
Drinking?
But that too.
I'm good at that.
Just like any other hobby, it gets more and more expensive. You need more and more equipment. So, I mean, within a matter of months, we were kind of living in a brewery. I mean, we had beer in the bathtub. We had equipment here and there. Everything, it really overtook everything.
Our neighbors are total beer heads.
Yeah, we must have looked like we were running a meth lab or something. But anyway, so it just kind of sparked the idea where, you know, not everyone has these huge sprawling landscapes where they have room for all this stuff or endless finances. So we thought we would bring something to the community where you could actually just show up, brew, and that's that. You don't have to clean up the mess. You don't really have
to know
what you're doing, you know?
Oh, look at that, huh? Yeah. That's Those look like business cards.
They are.
those look tasty.
So we have large workshops where we have up to 30 brewers that come, and they kind of just, it's a little setup like this, and everybody has their own brew station.
Nice.
So they're all brewing their own individual batch of beer. And what they basically take away from our workshop is a bottling kit also. So we teach them how to bottle their beer, how to ferment it at home. So really, once
it's weird, as you're saying this, I noticed that our backdrop is getting drunk, too.
Again?
it's pretty weird.
How did you even notice that?
He's a sailor. He's on shore leave. Give him a break.
Our set is a little tipsy, but that's okay. Listen, Jenny, I want to thank you so much for
Absolutely.
Coming out and showing us the home brewing. Where can people find you, and how can they get involved with this?
Well, they can certainly find us at our sponsor brewery, which is Helms. Helms Brewing Company is located in Kearney Mesa, so it's very local.
Oh, beautiful Kearney Mesa. Sure.
They have
right
great
by the
beer.
Courthouse. I'm familiar with that area.
Are you?
Yeah. One-stop shopping.
Yeah, go to the home brew, right to the courthouse. Yep.
Yeah, so you can come and find us at Helms. Like I said, that's where we brew and where you guys would be brewing if you came to brew with us also. Or you can find us at Line online. Our company's DIY Brew It Yourself, and we're brewyourselfsd.com.
That's fantastic. Thank you very much. Well, we're going to come. We'll bring the whole crew. Can we accommodate everyone,
great.
Or at
yes.
least me and Keith?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know.
Maybe not Keith. All right. Well, we'll bring Teelyn. Thank you so much, Jenny.
Thank
Appreciate you.
You
coming on the
Thank
show.
Thank you guys for letting
Brew It Yourself,
you.
Everybody.
Thank you.
All right, stick around. We'll be right back with KUSI's Allie Wagner.
Thanks, guys.
All right, we are back. So, I know everybody loves winning prizes, and tonight, two lucky audience members are going to win tickets to SPF 94.9, happening Sunday, June 5th. So, if you want to win prizes like this, just check us out on tonightinsandiego.com. Now, coming up, we have a very special guest. Ladies and gentlemen, you can see her every weekend morning on KUSI, Allie Wagner!
To my brother, Christian, and his girlfriend, Sam.
Shout out to Christian. How are you?
In the house tonight.
Yes.
I couldn't find the building, but it's cool.
That's how we like it. It's like a speakeasy. We just keep it on the down low.
I was like, does anybody else get lost? They're like, yeah, no, just.
We've only had two episodes, so we don't know yet. We're not sure.
Yeah, I'm the first one to be lost.
The first one to be lost.
Awesome. Hey, it's good to be the first.
Like the Padres of guests, I guess. I don't know. So, Allie, thank you so much for doing the show. I really appreciate it. As a person in broadcasting yourself and a wannabe person, I felt like you'd be a good person to pick your brain on how to do this job properly. For instance, just to start, how did you get involved in broadcasting? How did you get started in San Diego broadcasting?
Well, at 9 years old, my poor mom, I look at her and I go, man, watching Monday Night Football, I want to do that. And I think she probably had this look on her face like, wait, what? You want to be on what? All right, well, good luck. Let's figure out how to get you there. Okay. So I went to San Diego State. Obviously, I'm a Ramona Bulldog, San Diego State.
Very nice.
And started in radio. And then, well, I stumbled upon the Prep Pigskin Report. I was working at a Albertsons at 14th and Market for a while, and one of my customers who would bring me the sports page every day says, hey, if you ever come into contact with Paul Rudy, you tell him you know me and he will give you a job. And I'm like, okay. So one day I came in contact with Paul Rudy. I said, hey, I know Luigi. And he's like, all right, let's do an interview. Come work on the Prep Pigskin Report.
Like that? It just happened that quick? I mean,
I guess.
So I need to get a job at Albertsons is what you're saying.
Is that offer with Paul still on the table?
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
So that's a direct line into TV? I just paper.
Who knew?
Is that paper or plastic or TV job? Is that?
Go figure. So I was lucky enough to meet Paul Rudy, who has been my mentor, has given me every opportunity, and work for KUSI, the McKinnons, who own the station. You know, I begged and pleaded them to put me on TV, and I was so lucky to be here in San Diego where we have a station where you can kind of do that, and they're local, and you can lobby yourself in.
Was it, I mean, did anyone warn you about San Diego Broadcasting, or give you any if it was going to be easy to break into, or?
San Diego State Journalism, they go, working in San Diego, you realize you need to move to Montana, to the middle of nowhere, to start out in broadcasting. While that sounded like fun.
Yeah.
I
mean, we were going to do tonight in Montana, actually, originally. So we changed
the middle of
good
nowhere.
Good morning, Yuma. That's
good morning, Yuma.
My mom always was like, go work in Yuma. That'd be great. It's not that far. That sounds like fun.
In Montana, they have an actual pigskin report, I think, on pigskin. So that.
I can tell you, I grew up in Ramona. Pigs, not that fun. Not my favorite animal.
So they were telling you that it's impossible to get a job.
Yes.
But they didn't know about your Albertsons connections, did they? To get in. What kind of figures have you met? I assume that you've met a lot of sports figures and a lot of people.
I don't know. Who do you have on the desk here? LT, I know him.
Yeah, we got LT.
I know him.
We have a dragon from Mexico my mother gave me. I don't think you know him.
No, I don't know the dragon.
Do you know Obi-Wan Kenobi?
Yeah, you know Obi-Wan? I don't think...
I don't know Obi-Wan, but who in our sports world could be Obi-Wan? I'm like, gosh, Jerry Coleman, he was probably kind of like an Obi-Wan, right? I met Vin Scully the other day, opening day for the Padres.
Cool.
That was really cool. Took a very good sneaky selfie with
him
in the background.
How did he feel about that?
He was actually so cool. I mean, for those people who maybe don't know who Vin Scully is, probably he has been doing Dodgers games my life times 2 plus 20. Like,
yeah.
The entire time. So that's kind of like in my world, like, oh my gosh.
So you were like a fan. I saw the selfie is like,
oh, it's totally
he's in the background
out.
Of the selfie, like, look who's in the selfie.
I don't fan out very often, and I definitely fanned out for that.
Surprisingly, I actually did the same thing to you at the San Diego Film Awards. I tried to take a picture of her without her noticing. Look, I'm here with her. Like,
I hate when people do that. Just come up and take a photo.
Next time I will. Yeah.
Yeah. That's cool. You didn't bring your phone? We're not going to take a selfie now?
See, we do it right now. I know that you were hosting with Dallas for the San Diego Film
Awards. My boy Dallas,
yeah. What did you think about him?
Was he born in Dallas?
I think he was born. He definitely wasn't born in San Diego after that report. I don't know. What did you think about him disparaging the Padres like that? And do you think we should fire all the Padres?
Okay. So I was in the Padres locker room on Friday going, talking to people about how horrible we've been hitting right now.
Yeah.
Anyways, and I talked to Alan Zinter, our hitting coach. He's a new guy, you know, came in with Andy Green, and I'm like, okay, do you get a little nervous? We're kind of notorious. We had Phil Plantier, who was our hitting coach, then Mark Kotze. I mean, it's hard to keep a job as a hitting coach in San Diego.
I don't even know. What do they do? Just be like, hit the ball. Hit it.
Yes.
You get it. We need a new one of those.
You should do that job. Yeah.
I've been auditioning for that at Albertsons lately, so I'm going to work on that.
So he said, I go, are you a little nervous? He's like, it's the very beginning of the season. Like, can we have, more than 11 games to determine how we're going to be? And I don't know. Anyways, Will Meyer says, well, now we're in our own batting cage. We can practice some more. Anyways.
Oh, that'll make all the difference, their own batting cage. So they just keep going through different hitting coaches? And they just haven't found the one that...
You know what? It seems to me like we've gone through quite a few. I mean, it's known to be... It's a tough job to keep in San Diego when you look at our history of not really scoring runs.
Yeah.
So.
You used to have an inside track with Tony Gwynn, too, didn't you? What do you think he would say about
this? Oh, my gosh. Can I tell you, growing up in San Diego, I've been lucky enough that I got to interview Junior Seau and Tony Gwynn and Trevor Hoffman and all these people who you just kind of grow up idolizing, LT, all these guys. And getting to meet and talk to Tony Gwynn and ask him about, questions about steroids and what books are you reading.
This is off camera. He's giving you inside dirt on people?
Oh, yeah.
He would tell you, like, who's on steroids and stuff?
A little bit.
I
don't know. I would just ask some questions.
All right, Jesse, I'll admit it. I'm on steroids.
He's on steroids.
I knew it. I could spot it from a mile away.
He's got a performance-enhancing tie, too. I don't know if you can see that. It's very nice.
I will tell you, though, that's part of the fun. Part of it is getting to interview these people who you've grown up idolizing and getting to kind of know them a little bit. And that's, you know, I love being able to ask questions about when you had a good game or a bad game and knowing the answers why, then I don't quite get as upset.
Yeah. Do you think now Tony Gwynn would, like, recommend the Padres use steroids? Do you think that would be his to improve their hitting?
Just a little juice.
It's
cool. A little.
I mean, there's ways to get around that, right?
I mean, I don't know. Is there? Keith? Is there ways to get around that? We're not sure. We're going to find out.
Something like that, right? You know all about that. No?
I don't know much about performance at all.
No.
But I'm trying to learn. I really wanted to ask you, like, what the best way to do an interview was, but I think, from what we're doing, I think it's just riffing it and not being prepared at all. Is that how you do this?
That's
how you do an interview?
When I go into a locker room, I am very big on knowing all my stats and knowing, actually, you would never know this, you need to know where everybody went to college, because they all love to talk about college.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah, come on. In a locker room, they love to talk about that. Football locker room? That's all the banter is who went where and yeah.
You don't like embarrass some of the athletes that went straight from high school with that question?
Well, in football, you gotta go through the steps. But I would say that on the weekends, though, a lot of times it's much easier to just chit-chat with people.
And when you were in college, did you get interrupted when you were speaking at once?
Oh, that's in high school.
Oh, that was in high school.
I spoke at my high school graduation, and poor Calvin, he didn't get to go to the graduation, so he decided to streak during my speech. So that kind of prepared me for everything that happens on Good Morning San Diego and dealing with Dan Plant and Dave Scott. I kind of feel like that was training.
Yeah, you're ready for them to streak on TV.
At any time, I'm ready for anybody to do that. I'm prepared for anybody to run behind it.
Are you ready, Jesse?
I'm ready, Keith. I don't think, you know what, I'm not ready, Keith.
Okay, next
then
week.
Then we'll really see the steroids.
That's right. That's right. Well, thank you, Allie, for coming on the show. I really appreciate it. So they can catch you every weekend morning.
Every
on
weekend
KUSI.
Morning. Or hit me up on Twitter, Instagram, Allie Wagner TV.
That's fantastic.
And keep on watching.
Thank you so much. Allie Wagner, ladies and gentlemen. That's here for her. Stick around, everybody. We're going to be right back with your musical guest tonight, Caroline Korn. All right, we are back. Ladies and gentlemen, we got some more prizes to give away. Here we have two tickets to see Parachute at the San Diego House of Blues Thursday, April 21st. Also, one of our sponsors here has been generous enough, Rustic Meatballs. Everyone in our live studio audience tonight is getting a pair of balls. Pretty amazing. So like Oprah, if you just look under your seat, you'll find balls. Anyway, if you want to win prizes like this or be in the live studio audience, please go to tonightinsandiego.com to get your tickets. Coming up next, we have a very special musical guest, a young talent here in San Diego. Make some noise for Caroline Korn. Thank you for coming on the show, Caroline.
Thank you for having me.
So it says here that you started playing guitar when you were 6 years old.
Correct.
Did you get? I mean, that seems a little bit early to be getting into the into show business. What got you playing music so early?
My dad actually kind of threw me into guitar lessons when I was like maybe 6 or 7. But
so he forced you.
Yeah, pretty much. And then it kind of became a chore instead of a hobby. So I put it down until I was about 13 or 14.
Okay.
And then picked it up again.
Even starting at 13 is pretty early for music. Is that when you played your first gig when you were 13?
Yeah, I played my first gig when I was 13 at the House of Blues here in San Diego.
That's exciting. That's a pretty big first gig.
Yeah, it was probably the worst gig I've ever played.
It was the worst gig? The first one was the worst, and you stuck with it after that? Or did you quit
it was just
7 years?
It was me sitting on a stage by myself with an acoustic guitar, like looking straight down, terrified, playing for like my parents.
Okay.
Like the worst songs you'd ever heard. It was horrible.
So Nickelback.
Nickelback?
Exactly. Like probably probably worse than that. Mm. But yeah, and then so I did that for a while, and then I just started playing with a band, and then it kind of picked up from there.
And what's your band? Is there a name for your band, or is it just Caroline Corn?
It's Caroline Corn, and then Christian Jay and Declan are
okay.
My
so
band
are
as well.
They cool with not having a band name? That it's just your name for Caroline?
We're working on it.
You are.
Yeah, like we have okay, we have a few in the works
you have
right
some,
now.
With Caroline Corn and the Colonels. How about that?
I mean,
does that work?
I can see it working, maybe.
Are you sick of all the corn jokes?
In middle school, yeah.
Yeah.
It was a little much, but it's okay.
We have the humor of middle schoolers, so, welcome. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Jesse's stinky.
That's right. And Keith has cooties, so. So Caroline, so you started playing music at 13 years old, and
yeah.
House of Blues, that's like a pretty amazing gig, and you went back there to the House of Blues to play recently.
Correct.
How did that feel to be back later, you know, after having your worst gig ever there?
It was funny. I told the story on stage when I played about the show, and I was like, it's crazy to be back, because like this time it was like full confidence, like we'd been doing this for like 2 years now, and like we had a band, and there was actual people there to see
better.
It, which is really cool, instead of playing to ourselves.
And you guys are touring as well? You guys do touring, or you're playing out?
No, like mostly right now, just playing in San Diego. Like I'll do like some acoustic gigs in LA, and then I'll do just like open mics or just like little acoustic things. But besides that, it's just San Diego.
Okay, and when you guys travel, when you go up to LA, or you guys go on the road or whatever, do you get bored? Do you play any games when you're out there, or?
We'll do like, I don't know, just things to pass the time. Like just like eating or like, I don't know. Like
I know that one.
My drummer will like skate around or just like homework and downtime. I don't know.
I heard you're a slide.
Play a slide?
You're a slide
yeah.
player?
Yeah. Want to do it?
Let's try.
Okay.
All right. Can we do it right
now? All right. Let's do it right now.
Okay. Let's try.
All right.
You guys know slide? Here we go. Well, I already screwed that up. Hold on. Let's try that again.
One, two, and I'll do two, one. Almost there.
My girlfriend almost tried there. To teach me that for this, but anyway. So I lost that. I hate losing games. Here's the thing, Caroline. I have been wanting to join a band, and Teelyn keeps rejecting me. And so we
You can join our band.
Can I join your band? That was easy.
Band.
Look at that, Keith.
Yeah.
How about that? I got a job at Albertsons, and I'm in a band tonight. This
there
is
you
great.
Go.
But
yeah.
Here's the thing. On the show, I want to get a chance to play with the band. So we have a new segment that we call Playing with the Band. Are you willing to try a game
Let's
with us?
Let's do it.
All right, Keith, what's the game we got today?
This week we're playing Trickopedia. As we all know, the internet is a dark, festering cesspool of lies and deceit.
Except
and we've turned that into a game.
Except for North Korea, right?
What?
Not in North Korea, it's not.
No. No, in North Korea, they're vague booking.
That's right.
But the rest of the internet is a festering cesspool of lies and deceit.
That's true.
And that's our game. It's called Trickopedia. How it works is I'm going to list for you three Wikipedia pages.
Okay.
Two of them are real. One of them we made up. So our contestants will have a limited amount of time to pick which one is the fake Wikipedia page.
Okay, so it's like two truths and a lie. Have you ever played Two Lies and a Truth? This is the opposite. So we have to pick, I don't know math, but okay, so.
You pick the one I made up.
Okay, we're gonna pick the one Keith made up. You ready for that?
Got it.
So you want me to go first to show her how
Yeah.
It? Okay, so give me a Wikipedia page. Let's see if
the first category is diets. We
what?
Have the cookie diet.
This is,
you, don't know much
okay,
about
it. You're trying
those,
to stump me right out of the gate. Diets, okay. Diets, what's the first one?
We have the cookie diet.
Oh, I know that one's real. That's a tasty diet.
We have the cotton ball diet.
Cotton ball diet, okay.
And we have the coffee and cigarettes diet.
Okay. Well, being that I've done both the cookie and the coffee and cigarettes diet myself, I'm going to guess that cotton ball, no, but you can't eat cotton balls.
I'm sorry, Jesse, that is incorrect. The cotton ball diet is a real diet where you absorb juice into a cotton ball and eat it.
Get
That's
out.
A real page.
That's ridiculous.
And the cookie diet is a meal replacement plan where you get rid of meals and eat cookies.
Oh, I know that one.
I'm into that one too.
Yeah, we're into it.
Oh, totally.
All right, so let's give Caroline one.
All right, Caroline, all of yours are musical themed.
Okay.
The first category for you is album names. Okay. Ska-pocalypse Now. Funk Shui.
Okay.
Or Hip Hopopotamus. Which one is fake?
Hip Hopopotamus.
You are correct.
Yeah! you just took that from Flight of the Conchords. Is that where you got that from?
Yeah, it's a lyric in a song, but it is not an album. Ska-pocalypse Now is the first album for the band Mustard Plug, and Feng Shui was a 2008 solo album by John Oates. Okay. He should have stayed with Hall.
All right, so it's 1-0. Do I get one more chance at
this? You get one more. Okay. Your category is Animal Achievements.
What?
Animal Achievements.
Okay.
First, we have List of Animals with Fraudulent Diplomas. Next is okay. Non-Human Electoral Candidates.
Non-Human Electoral Candidates.
Okay. And then Animals Nominated for Achievement in Acting.
I think the first one is fake. What was that? The diplomas?
That is actually true. There is a list of animals with collegiate degrees. Also true is non-human electoral candidates. We've had dogs as mayors, Jesse.
Have we really had dogs?
We've had dogs as mayors.
I know we had a falcon or a falconer, but okay. So now that...
So it's 1-0. The last category is for Caroline. Okay. And this category is worth 50 points.
Okay.
You got to get this negative one.
What do I have right now?
You have 1 point.
You have 1 point, and now you get 50?
All right.
The category is band names.
All right.
First, we have Mac Sabbath.
Okay.
Then we have Triple Nipples, which I like to pronounce Triple Nipples. And finally, Jesse Egan and the Messy Vegans. Which one of these is fake, Caroline?
Maybe Jesse Egan and the Messy Vegan?
That is correct.
Yeah.
I do want that to be real, though. I want that band.
We could tour together.
We can do that?
Yeah.
I'll open for you.
Okay.
And our winner is Caroline.
Caroline's the winner.
Thank you.
Well, congratulations, Caroline. Hold on. I've got some prizes for you. And you know, we're very mature here, and I want you to have this can of rich and hearty chicken corn chowder.
Oh my God, thank you so much.
That's right. I've got some cream style golden sweet corn for you. Actually, you can never have enough. That's two.
Guys,
that's two,
this is so sweet.
Two sweet corns. We've got some honey cornbread.
Oh my God.
From the good people at Krusty's.
This is all for me?
That's all for you. And finally, corn Chex, and it's gluten-free. I don't know if you like that. Oh, and there's one more prize. You've also won one free date with our warm-up guy, Anthony Mays.
Yeah. Check that out.
Yeah. Because he says that maize is Spanish for corn. So
that's true. Isn't it pronounced like maize?
So I don't know if you want to take that or... anyway. Carolyn Corn, everybody. Let's hear it up for her. What a good sport.
What? Oh, my God.
Okay, we'll eat this corn together. Thank you so much for coming on the show. Yeah. Really appreciate it. We'll be right back, everybody. Let's hear it for her one more time. Thank you so much. All right, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Tonight in San Diego stage, Caroline Corn.
Honey, said, in your mouth we love this rainbow our embrace. Now put a hang over, ready, set, go. Now we're hung over, my head on your shoulder feels good. Now you're the one I wanna kiss and cry about. I'm the sad little boy on the playground, and you're handing me gold for school.
That is our show for the night. Thank you guys so much for watching Tonight in San Diego. You can check us out on tonightinsandiego.com. Also, please tweet us or hit us on Instagram and hashtag it hip hops hooray and send us a picture of your favorite craft beer in San Diego and win a prize. We'd like to thank our sponsors tonight from Lafayette Hotel, The Rock Offices, The House of Blues, and of course, Rustic Meatballs. Also, ladies and gentlemen, please make sure to check out our guests and follow them online. We've got Jenny Seabolt from Brew It Yourself, also Allie Wagner from KUSI, and to bring us out with one more song, please give it up for Caroline Korn.
Are you straight enough to tell me all the things that you couldn't say before? When your room is slowly turning into rainbows, your body's lying on the floor. It's alright, 'cause I like you best when you second guess everything that catches your interest. It's alright, 'cause I like you best when you're dressed in black. We're not in love, what did you expect? And I should